Hey everyone, so I have a question for you. Who am I? Who are these three furry animals? Do you know their names and what movie I'm referencing here? If you guess correctly, this is Chance on the left, Shadow in the middle, and Sassy on the right. Chance is the bulldog, Shadow is the golden retriever, and Sassy is the cat, and it's from a movie called Homeward Bound. And in the movie, they cross over a really treacherous and thrilling journey on the way back home through the California wilderness, and they finally make it home to their owners, and it's a beautiful homecoming. So why am I talking about this movie with three pets in it? Let's take a look. Today, I'm actually going to be talking about what are the benefits of becoming a chief of staff. And basically, we're asking the question, was it worth it? Like Homeward Bound, was it worth it to cross that wilderness of moving rivers, mountains, forests to get home? And this is some of the reasons why people become a chief of staff. We'll take a look here. Number one, you get exposure to senior leadership and decision-making processes. You actually are in the room where it happens. Shout out to Hamilton. Number two, you become a trusted advisor to the CEO and other top executives. They want to know your opinion, and they are trusting you with making sometimes a decision on behalf of them as their proxy. Number three, you learn how to effectively manage complex projects and priorities. Number four, you develop a deep understanding of the company and its operations. And so you have a pulse on the health of the company. You're doing KPI and performance management. Number five, you gain valuable skills in communication, negotiation, conflict resolution. This reminds me of the other video I've made on the hard skills and the soft skills for successful chief of staff. Those skills are super important on you becoming a better leader. Number six, you know how to navigate organizational politics and build strong relationships. The higher you go, the more people will fight over budget and also access to talent. And so you're gonna have to be able to be diplomatic and thread the needle in certain situations to get out of sticky situations and build strong relationships. That's number six. Number seven, you have the opportunity to influence strategic direction and drive change. You are basically the CEO whisperer. You are in the ear, sometimes both ears, of the CEO, and you can tell them where you want the company to go, and obviously you have to back it up with the reasons why, but you have a big outsized impact. Number eight, you will develop a broad network of contacts across the organization and beyond. Obviously, if you're interfacing with investors and the board, you're going to maintain those relationships, and that could be really useful beyond in terms of your exit opportunities. Maybe you want to found a company or you want to find a new job. You get exposed to a ton of stakeholders in the chief of staff seat. Again, I kind of hinted at this. Number nine, you have the potential to advance quickly, and you have many, many, many exit opportunities. I'm going to cover that in a separate video, but it's a skip level, amazing development opportunity as a chief of staff, and you will have many exit opportunities at your feet based on the relationships that you've built and also the hard skills, the soft skills, and leadership traits that you've demonstrated as a successful chief of staff. So those are the nine reasons why to become a chief of staff. It's an arduous journey, like Homeward Bound, but it is worth it for some folks. So those are some things to consider when you're thinking, should I do it or not? Thanks so much, and catch me on the next one.